In New Mexico, wildfire season typically starts in May and lasts until monsoon, which usually occurs early July. We can consistently rely on having wildfires every year. Climate change, I think we expect, will continue to exacerbate wildfires and the size and intensity of them in the Southwest.
In 2010, the New Mexico Environment Department's Air Quality Bureau wanted the Department of Health to become involved with smoke planning issues around burning permits and burners, and so we started participating. We developed a number of resources. For example, we had fact sheets, we had downloadable posters that could be put in clinics for healthcare providers or at community centers, for example. And then we also developed an interactive mapping tool, which allowed users to be able to look at where they lived and then look at different visibility distances in miles, 5 miles, 3 miles, and 1 mile, and then use that to try to decide if they needed to take any action to protect themselves from wildfire smoke.
So it turns out to be like a bullseye around their location, but it's a much better way than just actually trying to guess at distances, because most people really don't have any idea visibility-wise how far something is. And in New Mexico, where the visibility is usually really good, you can actually see 15 and 20 miles on a good day.
The worse the visibility gets, the worse the air quality tends to be. For example, if you can see more than 5 miles, your visibility is good and the air quality is pretty good. If you can see only less than a mile, air quality is pretty bad at that point. Wildfires produce a lot of different pollutants, including carbon monoxide, particulate matter, very fine particulate matter, which is what we're mostly concerned about, because that's what goes deep into the lungs and creates problems for people's breathing and for heart disease.
Before the tracking network came up with the 531 tool, we had a system which was wholly convoluted and complicated. A massive matrix of various colors and things. It was very difficult for us to use as people trying to help inform the public and for the public to understand.
The Health Department, the Air Quality Bureau, the BLM, the Forest Service, Fish and Wildlife, Park Service, you know, when there's a large fire, it becomes a team effort. To have one place where everybody can go, I think, is invaluable.
New Mexico Environmental Public Health Tracking really brings the core capacity to the state of New Mexico to address environmental health issues. What this means is that we have this talented, experienced, trained staff to investigate and monitor environmental health issues, and then to take that information and be able to inform and educate the community about these environmental health issues.